every single day?
My recollection of the process is that we are using Healthline to make contact with individuals. So once someone is advised that they are positive with COVID, they go through a conversation with the public health team around what will best suit their needs and reduce down risk. Following on from that, if they are then home isolating, then they have contact with our Healthline team.
And it should be daily, daily contact.
That's my recollection of the protocols that are in place, but there's a number of other protocols that they have for home isolation as well.
She's spoken to a family of six. The parents had COVID-19. They had sporadic contact from the Ministry of Health.
I would be happy to follow up. I won't ask for anyone's private details here, but I would be happy to follow up and see exactly what may have or may not have occurred in that case. But there are very clear protocols for how we try to consistently reach people. That tells us that they are indeed home isolating, but also allows us to check in on their symptoms and ensure that they're not deteriorating.
That would be great. But if I could just put to you a couple of things that this family said. They said that the support from the Ministry of Health has been disgusting and disappointing.
Well, again, I'm obviously not equipped to share what did or did not occur on the health team side, and I would rather have that information before I respond.
And what about this? They said that the Ministry of Health would have no idea right now if we were dead in a corner.
I would rather go away and find the details myself before responding to any accusations against the Ministry of Health.
I
don't want to make statements to speculate, because actually I've heard also of significant contact from Healthline, and you yourself have experienced some of the system and the way it works, so I would rather go and get
would
the details first.
Would that be good enough to you if that were the case?
I'm not going to make a speculative statement about what's occurred before I find out.
Just to get a bit beltway real quick, the remit to change the way that the Labour leader is elected.
Not beltway to we're standing in the Labour Party head office right now.
Very relevant then. What decisions have been made around that process?
I really should. I believe that the Labour Party president is going to put out some information on the outcome of remits at some point.
Or maybe Rob.
Maybe the General Secretary would like to speak that. Shall we just finish on getting a bit more, seeing if there are any other questions in the room? And maybe Rob would like to share the outcome of those.
On your conversation with Xi Jinping, what was his response when you reiterated our concern around Hong Kong?
Look, one thing that I can absolutely say is that New Zealand has been totally consistent on both voicing concerns on issues such as Hong Kong, but also on the situation of Uyghurs in China. Of course, we are very predictable then and being consistent about raising those concerns. And what I can say is that there was, considerable discussion and canvassing of those issues on both sides.
How was it delivering a conference speech? I know you don't like to call them slippers, but how was it delivering a conference speech?
In all birds.
In
all
birds?
They are all birds.
So
I will confess that unfortunately I left my high heels in the office, and as everyone in the gallery knows, I don't have all of my clothes from Auckland here in Wellington over the past 3 months, so my options at home were these. Thank you for asking.
Can I just go back to Xi Jinping?
Can we note again that they're all birds supporting New Zealand wall?
Chinese state media quoted you as saying that New Zealand...
Plus, I gave a speech under a desk, okay? And this is a headshot that we're meant to all be using here, okay?
Chinese state media quoted you as saying that New Zealand firmly believed the Beijing Winter Olympics would be a complete success. That wasn't in the New Zealand readout of the conversation. Is that what you said?
Oh, so look, I wished every success and to China in hosting. It highlighted again that whilst it wasn't a general practice for ministers to attend the Winter Games, that that we would be sending a team of New Zealand athletes, and that we, if I recall my words, wish them every success for the successful hosting of those games. So words to that effect.
There have been calls for a boycott though over the situation with Uyghur Muslims, and concerns expressed by, I think, foreign correspondents about the restrictions on reporting there. So
what I would, and what I would say there is, within that call, yes, mention was made of the Winter Games, but so too was the issue of the Uyghur people in China, and so too was the issue of Hong Kong, and this is an issue that New Zealand has been very consistent on, and I've raised both face to face and now in talks at the highest level with the president himself.
Were you invited to go back again to visit?
Oh, we had some discussion about the fact that, of course, you'll remember my last visit was in 2019, not long after the horrific events of March 15. And there was mention of, in the future, being able to make another visit that may be longer on the next occasion.
You there? You to China?
Yes. Okay.
Why did you can you?
Okay, so perhaps we'll finish with you, Jason.
Yeah, sure. Why did you decide not to go to Europe at the end after that? You said that there were some discussions about it.
Yeah. So look, what you will have heard me say is that even in the beginning, when I was asked about it, I was very clear that no final decisions had been made, for two reasons. First, of course, closely monitoring the domestic situation here, which of course is my primary focus, but also any visit was always going to be around the most. In a timely way around the free trade agreement negotiations and picking the time that is going to be most pertinent to those negotiations. So taking both into account, next year is going to looks like the best time to time that trade mission.
So wasn't it all about optics, this idea that the Prime Minister going overseas when we have the...
Well, that is, you know, no, as I've said, there's two reasons. And you'll note that you were the first to ask me about the trip, and I was very careful to say that we had not even at that time decided to undertake it. All right. Thank you, everyone.
Yes, are there the shame ones that you took for Europe? So happy to take any questions on the Labour Party conference.
What was the vote outcome on the Labour leadership?
Yep, so the annual conference this morning voted to... The annual conference this morning voted to change the way that Labor runs its leadership elections. The change that has been voted for is to allow the caucus an opportunity to replace the leader directly without reference to the electoral college if one leader, or one candidate, I'm sorry, gets two-thirds or more of the caucus supporting them. Of course, if no candidate gets that, then we go straight to the leadership election college as we have now. They've got a week. Yeah, caucus has a week after the position becomes vacant to either pass a motion with two-thirds supporting one candidate to become the leader, or if they fail to do that, then we move to the full electoral college.
And that applies both in opposition and in government?
Correct.
Because there's some concern about, you know, whether it was necessary to do that in opposition or whether it would be helpful. Sorry, maybe the other way around. Yeah,
correct. It's a change that occurs regardless of whether the party is in government or opposition. One of the arguments that's been raised is that any leader who in opposition can garner two-thirds of their own caucus is doing pretty well. You only have to look elsewhere in politics to see how hard that is.
Is the caucus agitating for a coup, do you think?
I don't think so.
But the worries from within the party that the six-week, you know, the whole roadshow thing is just too onerous and too drawn out, the actual process itself?
No, I don't want to speak on members' behalf, but that is not one of the...
That's what were some of the arguments.
Yeah, that wasn't one of the ones that came up in the debate. And one of the ways that you can see that is that in the event that the caucus is divided, we will go to the full leadership election college. And one of the reasons for that is that the ultimate owners of the Labor Party are the members of the Labor Party. And if we need the highest level of decision makers, if you like, within the party to sort out a deep disagreement, the party will do that.
Was there a policy debate about republicanism?
Not to my knowledge.
Should there be?
My role in this is to count the votes. I don't put up the motions.
There was a press statement that went out from
the Republican Party.
Yeah, so there was going to be a remit on. Don't have the straight hand, sorry. But you don't recall any remit around New Zealand moving to a republic with a